Hallelujah. We love the Lord because He first loved us. Amen. Amen. I'm excited to bring you a word on Saturday. You know something? This whole Saturday Word of God missing in action was actually because of the way I picked up my style. This morning word was born from my inspiration from the radio teachers that I was listening to when I go to work. And most of the radio teachers, their time on the radio was Monday through Friday, and they come back on Monday. So I began to pick that style to be the way I present the Word of God. But there's no reason why we should let a Saturday go free without hearing the Word of God. And because I promise that we're going to spend the next 7 days to look at the creation story, it is critical that I stick with day number five. What God did on day five is very important and significant. You know, so I want to share that with you on today. But I want you to trust and know that God has something in store for you this year, and the enemy cannot do anything about it. Amen. It is still new. I believe it's still fresh. The year is still fresh, and greater things He will do. Unto the Lord be all the glory. Amen. Amen. God bless you. I want to run quickly to my assignment. We are looking at the creation story and what the mystery it is for us to begin to understand. I said that day one, God created the calendar. Day two, God created vision. He created the dome for you to envision as the sky being the limit. And day three, He said that expect and you will see it. And day four, He began to hide our destinies behind the stars in heaven and cause us to shine by design. Hallelujah. I want to spend with you on day five, which is captured in Genesis chapter 1, the verse number 22 and 23. Genesis chapter 1, 22 and 23. The Bible says, "Then He gave the living creatures His blessings. He told the ocean creatures to increase and live everywhere in the ocean, and the birds to increase everywhere on the earth. Evening came, then morning." That was the fifth day. I'm going to take it again. There is something powerful I want you to capture today. "Then He gave the living creatures His blessings. He told the ocean creatures to increase and live everywhere in the ocean." And He says now, "Then everywhere in the ocean, then the birds will increase everywhere on the earth. Evening came, and the morning." That was the fifth day. Actually, the fifth day captured a little more, but I guess captured the ending part of the fifth day, so you can see how the fifth day ended. I want to say to you, I want to slow down and tell you that your 2019 must be better, will be better, and is designed to be better than your 2018. I'll say it again. Your 2019 will be better in the name of Jesus than your 2018. Your 2019 will be better than your 2018. That says the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, let me step back and show you what I'm looking at. Now, theologically speaking, the book of Genesis is the book of beginnings. And theologically, when we talk about Genesis, it is a book that you have to read by sitting on the edge of your seat, because everything that is in the book of Genesis, especially chapter one going, is called, based on theological principle, called the law of first mentioning. In other words, everything that is mentioned in the book of Genesis, it's the first time it's being mentioned, so it's treated as the mother of all things. In other words, it is based on Genesis that you use to interpret all the other portions of the scripture. Now, step back and let me show you why I want you to capture this revelation. Now, you understand that God is creating existence from simplicity to complexity. From okay things to better things. Let me pause and break it down. When you consider what is happening on day five, for the first time in creation, we hear the word barak, which is bless. And we never heard bless in day one. We never heard the word bless in day two. We never heard the word bless in day three. We never heard the word bless in day four. We only hear that in day five, when God created living creatures. So you notice that He started with elements. He started with elements. He started with the sun and the stars, and He moves on to plants. And from plants, now He begins to put stars in the air. So all of that are supposedly things that do not have life in them. The plant do have some form of life, but you notice that life is developing in its complex form as the days go by. And so we come to day 5 and we notice that God is switching from just plants and stars into actual creatures, and only actual creatures can be blessed. 2019 needs you for that year to be called a blessed year, because only creatures, only living things can contain a blessing. The grace of a blessing cannot be put on a calendar. 2019 needs you to be blessed. What I'm saying is that the barak, the blessings of God, if you want to capture it on screen, you need a human being, because blessings can only come upon humans. You can't bless a man day. God bless the last day, as we will see, but we will notice that the blessing of God actually comes upon living creatures. But that is just a side dish. My main message to you is that understand the way God thinks, the way God moves. God that you saw on day one was doing something that was not as big as what he did on day two. So what I want you to understand, that the best is yet to come. The mystery of day 5 is that with time, God does better things. That is why the Bible says he taken away the first to establish the second. That is why the covenant, that is why theologically we call it the increasing knowledge of God. Do you understand that? The best is yet to come. So let me frame it this way. I want to slow down and tell you that everything that is going to happen in life, if you want the best, you have to wait, because it's going to get better with time. God does things better with time. That's why the old covenant was scripture says the old covenant was obsolete, because a better covenant was taking place. So by understanding that, you understand that therefore you that you were in 2018, a better you is about to come forth based on the law of God doing better things with time. And that same template is what shows up in, and when we finish the 7-day creation, you notice that God was doing better things one day at a time. So what you saw on day one was not as better as what you saw on day two. And what you saw on day two was not as better as what you saw on day three. That is why when you come to day 5 for the first time, he introduced complex creatures. So I came to let you understand that in 2019, your better is about to show up. I said that, oh my God. So what I'm saying is that it is spiritually and it's legally, it is creationally logical for you to know that your 2019 is going to be better than your 2018. And it goes without saying that therefore your 2020 will be better than your 2019. So I want you to understand that it is spiritually correct for you to expect better things this year. It is spiritually correct for you to know that your life is designed to get better with time. In the mind of God, you're supposed to be better this year than last year, because that is the order of creation. Creation is designed to increase and get better with time. So you don't have to go to any prophet. It is just Bible that this year will be better than last year. So expect that and understand that that is the order of things. Because we come in day 5 and the light goes on in my head. Ding, 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 ding. God has stepped into a better thing. They are new every morning. They are new every year. Great is his faithfulness. So I want to encourage you on today to understand that your 2019 will be better than your 2018 by the law of creation. By the law of creation, things get better as the day go by. Things get better as the day go by. So rest assured that your 2019 will be better than your 2018, because God always. So you are hearing me, and it looks like you didn't marry last year. Be happy, because if God help me, because what it is that a better marriage will happen. And you don't have to go far to understand what I'm saying, because it's true on many levels. It's true. You got to live your life. But the point is that the people God has delayed, he has better things for. And you will discover it soon when I finish the 7-day series. But I just want to give you this Saturday reminder that your 2019 will be better than your 2018 by the law of creation. Because with time, God does better things. And the reason is because God is a progressive God. You call it the progressive revelation of God. There are certain things that only Paul understood because Paul came later. I tell you, your life is going to get better with time. I declare it so, I speak it so, and I confess it so, that your life is going to get better with time. I say your 2019 is going to be better than your 2018. Understand it that way, think in that line, and know that that is how it's going to be. You are going to go forward. And so finally, the Bible said, God said to them, increase and multiply. He spoke to the ocean. And now you notice that from the ocean, he goes to another higher level of creation, which is now the animals on the earth. So you see how it's increasing in quality. Then he comes to the final, most highly quality creature called man. And it says, we have hit the apex. We have finished with the template of creation. I declare you will finish well. God want me to tell you that you will finish well. Now let me relax and explain this way. You are designed to end well. God has put a format. God has put a protocol. God has put a template in place that everything that he makes must be looking excellent, or the best comes later. Or by the time he's finishing the work, his best creation, his best masterpiece comes last. The most handsome, oh God, your best friend, oh God, help me. I don't know how to express it, but what I'm saying is that your best life is ahead of you. It's not behind you. If you follow God, your best life is in front of you. Because in the order of creation, God always puts so just let that go. Let 2018 go, because it wasn't your best year. Your best year is this year. And when you finish this year, let it go, because your best year is next year. Because God is going to show you new things. God is going to bring you better people. God is going to, because that is how creation, I'm not making this up. That is the template. That is the first order of things called the law of first mention. That if God created things in 6 days, and the thing he did on 6 days, on this day six, was better than what he did in day one, understand that then with time, God does better things. So a better marriage is coming. A better life is coming. Oh my God, I declare it for you. And this is for you to see it. If you don't know what I'm saying, the enemy will destroy you. If you don't know this revelation I'm giving you, the enemy will rob you of your joy and make your life deteriorate. The enemy will whisper to you. But now that you know that you are supposed to do better this year, you stand and you declare that this is my best year. Now that you know by revelation that you're supposed to enjoy a better year, you will stand and be bold and declare and go after it. You will expect a better year, because it is designed so that your latter days should be greater than your former. It is designed that your end shall be better. It is designed that the second will be better than the first. That is why the second Adam was greater than the first. I don't want to upset myself. That is why God always reserved the best wine last. Is somebody now catching the revelation? So the best man is coming. The best wife is coming. Oh, those who left you, they've lost it, because the best you is coming. The best is always at last when it comes to God. So 2019 is going to be better than 2018. Let me pray with you. Father, we give you thanks, we give you glory, we give you honor. I thank you that we are going to enjoy the best deeper with you, deeper with understanding that which you have caused us to receive. We honor you, Holy Spirit, for such a revelation of the fact that we should sit back and expect a better year, no matter what happens. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.